Hello children, good evening all of you. Welcome back to fourth day class of polynomials and factorization. Children, in yesterday's class we learnt about factor theorem and problems on application of factor theorem and factorization of quadratic polynomial. Children, in today's class we will learn about factorization of cubic polynomial. Factorization of cubic polynomial. What is cubic polynomial, children? Cubic polynomial means if degree of a polynomial is 3, then it is said to be cubic polynomial. So let's take a polynomial x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. Is it a cubic polynomial or not, children? Since its degree is 3, it is a cubic polynomial. Okay. Now, how to factorize this cubic polynomial? Let's recall, children, in yesterday's class, quadratic polynomial x square plus 3x plus 2. It is factorized as product of two linear polynomials. If you do this, you will get x plus 1 into x plus 2. So, x square plus 3x plus 2 quadratic polynomial is factorized as product of two linear polynomial. So, since its degree is 2, it is product of two linear polynomials. What is the degree of cubic polynomial? Its degree is 3. Therefore, it is factorized as product of three linear polynomials. But what are those linear polynomials and how to find these linear polynomials, we will check, children. So, to factorize this cubic polynomial, first we have to find one linear polynomial by trial and error method. If I write 1 in the given polynomial in place of x, what will be the answer? We will check. P of 1. That means in the given polynomial in place of x, I will write 1. X cube, 1 cube minus 3x square. That means 3, 1 square minus 9x, 9 into 1 minus 5. 1 cube means it is 1 minus 3 into 1 square. 1 square means 1. 3 1 ja 3. Minus 9 1 ja 9 minus 5. What is the value of this, children? 1 minus 3 minus 2. Minus 2 minus 9. Minus 11. Minus 11 minus 5 minus 16. Since the value of P of 1 is not equal to 0, it is not a 0 of the given polynomial, or it cannot be written as factor of this polynomial. Now we will check one more value, P of minus 1. That means in the given polynomial, instead of variable, we have to write minus 1. Minus 1 cube minus 3 into minus 1 square minus 9 into x. 9 into minus 1 minus 5. Minus 1 cube. You all know, children, what is minus 1 cube? It is again minus 1. Minus in and minus 1 square. Minus 1 square, it is plus 1. So minus 3 into 1. Again minus into minus plus. 9 1 ja 9 minus 5. So, minus 1, minus 3, 1, yeah, 3, plus 9, minus 5. Minus 1, minus 3, minus 4, and minus 5 is minus 9, plus 9, it is 0. Since P of minus 1 is equal to 0, here, x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial. Given polynomial P of x. How can you say this, children? If x minus a is factor of given polynomial, then p of a is equal to 0. If x plus a is factor of given polynomial, p of minus a is equal to 0. So here, since p of minus 1 is equal to 0, p of minus a 0, therefore x plus a is factor. So p of minus 1 0, therefore x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial p of x. Without trial and error, if we didn't get p of minus 1 is also not equal to 0, we have to check again for p of 2 and p of minus 2, p of 3, like that. To get the 0 at any value, we have to check this in a trial and error method. Once we get any value as 0, then we will proceed to next process. Okay, children? Children, so x plus 1 is a factor of x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5. So we got one linear polynomial. Next, how to find other two? So we have to divide this x plus 1. We have to divide the given polynomial x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5 with x plus 1. You all know the process of division, children. How to do? First term of dividend is x cube. And the first term of divisor is x. X cube by x. So x into x into x by x. X and x getting cancelled, and the remaining term is x square. This x square is the first term of our quotient. Now what we have to do? This x square into divisor, x plus 1, x square into x, that is x cube. We have plus here, x square into 1, it is x square. Now, we will write that x cube plus x square. Now, subtraction. In subtraction, the sign will be changed. Plus x cube and minus x cube getting cancelled. Minus 3x square, minus x square. Both are negatives. So we have to add this and write the symbol minus. So minus 3x square, minus x square is minus 4x square. Now, along with the sign, these numbers comes down. Minus 9x, minus 5. Okay. Now, what we have to do, children? Again, the first term of this divide by first term of divisor. So, along with the sign, we have to write minus 4x square by x. So, minus 4 into x square means it is x into x. X and x getting cancelled. Minus 4x. So, we have minus 4x. So, that minus 4x is next term of our quotient. So, what next? This minus 4x is multiplied with the divisor x plus 1. So, minus 4 into x. Minus 4x square. Here we have plus and here it is minus. Minus into plus, minus. So, 4x into 1 is 4x. That minus 4x square minus 4x and minus 4x. Again, subtraction means symbol, sign is changing. Minus becomes plus. So, minus 4x square plus 4x square getting cancelled. Minus 9x plus 4x. It is minus 5x. Minus 5 comes down. So now, again, repeating the process. First term of minus 5x by first term of divisor x. X and x getting cancelled. Minus 5. So this minus 5 is the next term of our quotient. Now what we have to do? this minus 5 is multiplied with the divisor x plus 1. So again, minus 5 into x, minus 5x, again plus and minus, minus 5 into plus 1, it is minus 5. And the term minus 5x minus 5. Again subtraction, minus becomes plus. So minus 5x plus 5x, minus 5 plus 5 getting cancelled, 0 is the remainder. Okay children, since 0 is the remainder in the division, x plus 1 is a factor already we know. And this quotient x square minus 4x minus 5 is also factor of given polynomial. Okay children, so that means x cube given polynomial x cube minus 3x square minus 9x minus 5 can be written as x plus 1 into x square minus 4x minus 5. So we write the cubic polynomial as product of one linear polynomial and product of one linear polynomial and one quadratic polynomial. Now, this quadratic polynomial can be factorized. We know the process how to do this into product of two linear polynomials. Okay, children? Now, we will do this. Now, x square minus 4x minus 5. How to do this? First, quotient of x square, it is 1 into what is constant? Minus 5. 1 into minus 5. Minus 5. Yesterday we did this factorization of quadratic polynomial. Now, so factors of 5 are only 1 and 5. So 1 into minus 5 are minus 1 into 5. So what we have to get, if we add these two terms, we have to get minus 4. So here, plus 1 minus 5 gives minus 4. So we will take this only. So x square, now minus 4x can be written as plus 1x minus 5x. Instead of minus 4x, we are writing plus 1x and minus 5x. And same minus 5. Now, in these two terms, x is common. X square means two x's are there. One x is writing outside the bracket. Remains one more x. Plus, x is outside, so plus 1. Now, in these two terms, minus 5 is common. So, since minus 5 are right outside the bracket, the remaining term is x. Already I wrote minus outside, so it will become plus. So, 5 already I wrote. So, what will be the remaining term? 1. X plus 1, x plus 1. So, if I write x plus 1 outside, what are the remaining terms here? X minus 5. So, x square minus 4x minus 5 can be factorized as product of x plus 1 and x minus 5, two linear polynomials. That is equal to x plus 1 into x square minus 4x minus 5 means x plus 1 into x minus 5. So, this cubic polynomial is factorized as product of three linear polynomials. X plus 1, x plus 1 and x minus 5. Okay children? Okay children? This cubic polynomial factorization you will get in your exercise 2.4. You can do all those problems. Now we will move to another topic, algebraic identities. First, if x plus 5 is equal to 8, what is the value of x here? You all know children. What is the value of x here? X is equal to 3. If I write x is equal to 4, is it the statement true? Is it the equation will be correct? No, it is not correct. That means in place of x, we have to write only 3 in the given equation. If y square is equal to 16, what is the value of y here, children? Y may be plus 4 or minus 4. 4 is 16. Or minus 4 into minus 4 is also 16. So here y means we can write only plus 4 and minus 4. Other than these two values, we cannot write any value instead of y in this equation. Again, a into a plus 1 is equal to 6. Here, what will be the values of a? You can check it later, children. Now I am writing a is equal to 2 and minus 3. If I write a is equal to 2, 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1, 3. 2, 3 is 6. If I write minus 3, a means minus 3. A plus 1, minus 3, plus 1. Minus 3 plus 1, it is minus 2. Minus 3 into minus 2. Minus into minus plus 3, 2 is 6. Okay, children. In this equation also, a into a plus 1 is equal to 6. A values are either 2 or minus 3. Other than these two values, we cannot replace A with any other value. These all are equations. Then, what is identity? Identity means, for any value of variables, it is true for the given equation. If I write a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. For any value of a and b, if I write a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 2 at a time, it is true for a plus b whole square is equal to definitely a square plus 2ab plus b square. Once we will check, children, a plus b, a means 1 plus b. 1 plus 2 whole square. 1 plus 2 whole square means 1 plus 2, 3. 3 square means 3 is multiplied 2 times. 3, 3 is 9. Now I will find these values. A square plus 2ab plus b square. A square, a is 1 square plus 2 into a means 1, b means 2 plus b square. 2 square. 1 square is 1 plus 2 1 ja 2, 2 2 ja 4 plus 2 square 2 2 ja 4. 1 plus 4 5 plus 4 9. See, children, here a plus b whole square is equal to 9. At the same time, a square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to 9. You can check it for any other two values. If you take a is equal to minus 1 and b is equal to 2, you get a plus b whole square, which value? That value only comes for a square plus 2ab plus b square. That means, so for all the values of variables, so I will write what is identity. Okay, children, identity. Identity, an algebraic identity means an algebraic equation that is true for all values of variables occurring in it. That means a plus b whole square. Here variables are a and b. This a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square is true for all the values of a and b. In 8th class, you got some more algebraic identities. Do you remember, children? A minus b whole square. A plus b into a minus b. And one more identity is there. X plus a into x plus b. What are the formulas for this? Do you remember, children? Recall it once. I will write on the board. Now we will do some problems using these identities. Once we recall, children, a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. X plus a into x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus b into x plus a into b. Use suitable identity to find the product of 1 plus x into 1 plus x. How to do this, children? 1 plus x into 1 plus. These are binomials. You know how to do the multiplication of two binomials. First, let this is a 1 plus x. It is multiplied with 1 and with x. That means 1 plus x into 1. Here we have plus. Again, 1 plus x into x. First, we will take 1 plus x as a single term. So, this single term multiplied with all the terms in this 1 plus x. Next. Now, 1 is a single term. So, 1 into 1, x into 1. 1 into 1 plus x into 1. Plus. Again, 1 into x plus plus. So, here it is plus. X into x. 1 into 1, 1 plus x into 1, x plus 1 into x, x plus x into x, x square. 1 plus x, 2x plus x square. Can we add any other terms, children? 1 plus 2x plus x square. Can we add any other? No, we can't add or subtract if their degree is different. Okay. So, 1 plus x into 1 plus x. By using the product of two binomials, we did this. But, using these identities, we can find the product of these two linear polynomials very easily. So, 1 plus x into 1 plus x. You know, children, x into x is x power 2. So, 1 plus x into 1 plus x can be written as 1 plus x power 2. So, 1 plus x whole square. So, which identity is suitable for this 1 plus x whole square? You see, first one, a plus b whole square. You comparing with that. In place of a, we have 1 here. In place of b, we have x here. So, 1 plus x whole square. 1 plus x whole square is in the form of a plus b whole square. That means a is equal to 1 and b is equal to x. Now, from the first identity, from a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, we can write 1 plus x whole square is equal to